This definitely tastes good. I don't feel bad at all. Gooey cinnamon. Veggie bacon by Money Star. Aunt Jemima pancake mix. And just some eggs and some fresh peaches. So gives me some hot sauce. I can get right now. Hey, peach. Do you think that's a Georgia peach? I don't know. Let me taste it. We're gonna start off with this brush here.
It's been a long day, you just wanna go away. You can't sleep at night, and now I'm here. Can't promise tomorrow, you're gonna feel out of day.
But I couldn't walk away from it, and I said, you know, I'm just gonna go ahead and get it. And I just have to make some changes for a little bit. I just have to make a few changes, and I went to go check out flowers can get the best quality while they're still here. And they can live a little bit longer. And I'm going to tell you, I filled my flowers up with alkaline water as soon as I got them and kept them in water. And they've done pretty good so far. And when I got them from the store, they wasn't like in the greatest health because I did get the stock on sale. And you know, when you get flowers from a grocery store, they're not always perfect. But the great thing about flowers is you can be creative with them. And you can clean them up and make them where you want them to look in your arrangement. You just find the better stems and you use them. Now, I really want to put this arrangement together New Year's Eve. But I said, no, I'm going to wait till New Year's Day where I got sunlight coming in from the house and the house is nice and quiet. My son is so full. I cook spaghetti and meatballs. Yes, vegetarian meatballs. Pluck the eucalyptus.
And then into the twine.
Sprays here with olive oil. Here she. juice in the bag. So, okay. It looks fresh.
Shirt inside the washer room, you know.
Okay. It's really crunchy. Yeah, I'm definitely not disappointed. Got me some mozzarella cheese. Got Kraft. Gonna add some carnation milk. This is really important. Don't forget the milk. This is why you need a big pan. You know, mix it all together. Milk, the eggs, the cheese, the butter, all of it mixed together. It's going to all bake together. And they all play an important role. So, you miss one ingredient. Oh, my God. Now, some people add salt and pepper and all that stuff to the macaroni and cheese. I don't do all that because the cheese already has a salty flavor plus the butter. So, some more mozzarella cheese. And hug every single day. And she says, oh, I'm an introvert. I don't deal with people like that. And he says, well, you're going to have to. This is the only way you're going to be able to break down those barriers that you got. And she was like, oh, my God, that's crazy. I don't want to hug. I'm not a hugger. I'm not a hugging type person. It started to frustrate her because she literally had to go out and find 7 strangers to give a hug to. Now, I'm going to tell y'all what's funny. I do it all the time. I meet people. I talk to people. Children. I love children. I love them. They're so
beautiful. You know why? Because I feel like their spirits see everything so pure. And in that moment of their life, they're not judging you, you know? So I love children. But yeah, and I love old people. I love old people. I'm talking about like people like 80s. Yeah, well, if you're 60, 50, 55, 60, 70, you're not old yet. Y'all still got it going on. Yeah, still young. Yeah, but anyway, but 80, 90 years old. Oh my God. And then if I'm in the presence of someone who's like, which I was at one point, 98, I was thinking, oh my God, this is closest to heaven I'm going to get. I'm next to someone who's 98 years old, you know. I love old people because it's like they go back to being beautiful children, you know. Just, I love old people. They've been there. They've done that. They did it all. Just living in a flow of life, you know. She called her friend up. And yeah, she called her friend up and told him, she says, you know, I got to give seven strangers a hug. And I'm not really all that comfortable. I'm actually kind of scared. And he says, well, we're in New York. We can go to Central Park and we can find a whole lot of strangers.
My mom told us that she was taking us to the beach. Start with a C. I can't remember right now. Was it Chick Beach or Cheetah Beach? Anyway, it was a beach in New Jersey, which was far from Newark. Because I'm just trying to get like underneath my cheekbones. And I know I don't need to be contouring my cheekbones, but it's just fun and I just like to see the difference. My skin at 46. I gotta admit, I truly love my skin. When I was younger, I suffered with so much acne. People literally picked on me because my skin was so bad. Yeah. face was so bad, it hurt me. I didn't even want to go outside. I didn't want to go to school, nothing. So I started giving up the Pepsi. I didn't go cold turkey, it took a while. But then I noticed my skin started to clear up. It didn't clear up all the way. I still have like those bumps and like turning, like they're not really bumps, they're like knots. You feel like you could squeeze it and try to get a little bit out until you think it's gonna go down. It get worse, those bumps. And then someone told me, stop eating like a lot of sugary candy. Gave up a lot of the candy, like I eat the candy, but not, I eat it in moderation, kind of like. And I noticed that my face started clearing up. And then I stopped, I watched what I eat, like certain foods that would break me out. I noticed like after I eat, I would get bumps on my face, and then I knew it was the food. So I would, you know, change up something a little bit. I know I take the rest of this on the brush and I kind of just go under my chin. And it's amazing because this makeup really matched me really good. That I don't really have to do too much to my neck. But I just like to use up all the makeup. I'm kind of frugal. Makeup too expensive. I think that matte makeup was $33. And then the Laura Mercier was $48. Yeah, I almost used every single bit. Yeah. Okay, I got my makeup on now. I'm just gonna kind of scratch my nose because you know how you get creases on your nose and your makeup break. My makeup haven't broke. You know, thank God. This cute little Sephora brush is so cute. I only got one. I'm doing it really good because I don't want like no harsh line on my his brush is really soft, but it's firm at the same time. Seeing no one special.